Hi guys, it's Quinn's Ideas here, and in the midst of everybody waiting for the Dune trailer, being really excited about the Dune trailer, Apple TV, or whatever the production company is called, said, screw it, we're just going to release the Foundation trailer. And my God, the Dune trailer, better bring it, because the Foundation trailer is epic. This is way higher quality than I ever thought. I knew they were working on something with Foundation, but I was not expecting anything like this. It is absolutely phenomenal. So if you don't know about Foundation is basically the original Galactic Empire. So if you're into Star Wars, Dune, Hyperion, any type of science fiction that involves a Galactic Empire, it started with Foundation. Isaac Asimov was the original. This is the science fiction series. So people have been trying to make this for a really, really long time, and I understand why it hasn't gotten made, because Foundation is kind of like a weird story. It takes place over 1,000 years. So if you don't know what Foundation is about, let me basically give you the rundown of what's going on in the Foundation series. So basically, you have this guy, Harry Seldon, who has invented this form of science, mathematics, which has incredible predictive powers. So it's almost like prescience in Dune, except not quite. It's more mathematical, kind of scientific grounded form of prescience. It's basically prescience in Dune, but calculus. And so through use of his study in psychohistory, through use of implementing this science that he's invented, he basically comes to the realization that the Galactic Empire is about to fall. Now, this is a huge galactic empire. It's sprawling. There's 25 million planets. It's been going on for so long that they don't even remember where Earth is. They think, oh, Earth is somewhere in this general vicinity, but we don't know exactly where it is. So yeah, that's an idea in Dune as well, that Earth is like kind of lost in the midst of time. So that's a little bit more of the influence for sure. And so you got Foundation, it opens up with this young character coming to the planet Trantor, which is this awesome planet that's encased in technology. He's coming to meet Harry Seldon, and he gets wrapped up in this whole plot. So like I said, Harry Seldon has realized that the Galactic Empire is headed for a pretty severe downfall and then a Dark Ages, and he tells them that it's going to happen within several hundreds of years, but he's actually lying, and it's actually going to happen much sooner. So his idea is to go to this wasteland planet and create the Foundation. And so wasteland planet, obviously Dune, wasteland planet, Hyperion, wasteland planet. Again, this is where these ideas are coming from. This is the original. So the idea is to go to the wasteland planet and create the Foundation. And the goal of the Foundation would be to gather all human knowledge in the universe in one place and create the Encyclopedia Galactica. And of course, if you've ever seen Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy or read Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, Douglas Adams, that is where that idea comes from. That is a parody on Asimov's work here, the Encyclopedia Galactica. Hitchhiker's Guide is very, very funny. Definitely check that out if you haven't seen it. But that is, of course, where that comes from. And then, of course, anyone that's read even a little bit into Foundation knows that, of course, the actual goal of the Foundation was not just to gather all human knowledge, but also to reestablish the Galactic Society after the fall of the Old One, which Harry Seldon predicted. Now, this trailer is sick. Like I said, so much more high quality than I ever expected. The guy playing Harry Seldon is a very famous actor who I can't name right now. The name will pop up right here. He looks fantastic. He looks exactly like I would have imagined Harry Seldon. There's a lot of, too, from this trailer, I noticed a few Dune notes. It seems like they've been looking at Dune art, looking at Dune material. A lot of the costumes kind of looked like the Dune miniseries, actually, which was very interesting because a lot of those costumes weren't great in the miniseries, in my opinion. And I'm also definitely getting some Bene Gesserit vibes from some shots here, some Guild vibes from some shots. It all looks really sprawling and epic and high quality, like they're sinking a lot of money into this. And like I always say, putting a lot of money into something and making it pretty doesn't necessarily mean it's going to be good. Foundation is a very, very, very hard story to adapt, and I don't know how they're going to do it, but it does look like from the trailer and what we've seen that they are going to go for the full 1,000 years. They are going to show you the full decline and rise of the new empire and all the turmoil that they face in between, which will be very interesting. But the reason that that is kind of weird for a TV show is because you don't really stay with any one character for that long. The book jumps hundreds of years pretty consistently, so like there's no main characters. So it'll be interesting to see how they handle that, and if they change that, then it won't be Foundation necessarily. So really the key here and the glue here is going to be the performance of Jared Harris. Now Jared Harris is a phenomenal actor. I've seen him in a few things. He's in The Expanse. He's in Mad Men, which is one of my personal favorite shows ever, and he's excellent in that. So I have no doubt that he can carry the role, but can he carry the whole show? We will see. So Harry Seldon is the only character that shows up consistently because he's recorded himself on holographic devices, and he shows up at predetermined points in time to offer advice or whatever it is to the people of the Foundation, because they face various issues along the way, and he is there to be kind of like a guide from the past. Actually, the concept of psychohistory is very interesting. It kind of implies that there is like kind of a predetermined nature to the universe, which is very interesting, because if you look at the way Frank Herbert is presenting prescience in Dune, the whole thing about the Golden Path was that Leto II was trying to free humankind from predetermination, was trying to free humankind from prescience. So it's almost like anti-Asimov, if you look at it in that way, which is very interesting. So yeah, this show is definitely on my radar. I do not have Apple TV, but I might just have to get it to check out Foundation when it comes out in 2021. And like I said, this might just suck out a little bit of the excitement from under the Dune trailer. I don't know how many people are super hyped about this like me, but I am very, very hyped about this. And it just honestly makes me personally more excited, because I'm like, if Apple TV can do this with Foundation, what are we going to see with Dune? What is it going to be like when we see the worm and the Dune Empire come to life? So it's awesome to see this. It's awesome to know that more classic science fiction is being adapted. I am here for it all. Let's get as many done. Let's get Hyperion done next. Hyperion will be an epic one to do. Let's get them all out there and done well. Throw buckets of money at classic science fiction. That's all I gotta say. Thanks guys for watching. Make sure you like and subscribe if you want to support Quinn's ideas, and hit up the paypal.me link in the description. And also check out Taddea. We've crossed 32,000 in funding in just a week. Over 800 backers. We are absolutely killing it. You can pick up Taddea, get it on presale right now on Indiegogo.